Hi guys, Mr. Newmobile here. Apple iPhone 12, release date and new design. Please subscribe followed by the bell. You can also keep up on Facebook, Twitter by clicking the links in the description. The new iPhone 12 wasn't announced at the Apple September event, but we're expecting to see the new series of phones at a separate event either later in September or in October, with October 13 currently looking to be the most likely date. Apple's September 15 event focused on the Apple Watch 6, Apple Watch SE, iPad Air 4, a new iPad, the Apple One subscription services, and the launch of a new service called Apple Fitness Plus. So what do we expect for the iPhone 12 when it does eventually arrive? In a first for Apple, it's expected the new iPhone could be joined by as many as three other phones. These are rumored to be called the iPhone 12 Max, iPhone 12 Pro, and iPhone 12 Pro Max, though recently a leaker has suggested that the basic iPhone will be called the iPhone 12 Mini, and that what we were previously thinking of as the iPhone 12 Max will be called the iPhone 12. In any case, there should be more iPhone choice than ever this year, especially once you factor in the iPhone SE 2020, which launched earlier in the year. We're expecting some big upgrades from Apple, including the first 5G iPhone. With 5G networks rolling out across the world, this will make the new phones far more future-proof than the iPhone 11 range. Leaks and rumors also suggest that the iPhone 12 Pro models will get a lighter scanner, just like the iPad Pro 2020, and we've also heard talk of new screen sizes, starting out at a tiny 5.4 inches and topping out at a big 6.7 inches. The big upgrade in power is all but confirmed, and that could have wide-ranging effects on the battery life too. The A14 Bionic chipset seen in the new iPad Air 2020 could be the upgrade many have been waiting for. October 13 currently looks to be the most likely date for the iPhone 12 launch. The most recent evidence for that is a source at a mobile network claiming as much and adding that pre-orders will open on Friday, October 16. Prior to that, John Prosser, a leaker with a mixed track record, had said that the iPhone 12 range will be announced on the week commencing October 12. That would likely mean an announcement on October 13, since Apple often unveils things on a Tuesday. According to Prosser, pre-orders for the iPhone 12 and iPhone 12 Max would apparently then open on the same week, probably Friday, October 16, based on Apple's past form. We take these claims with a pinch of salt, especially as Mark Gurman, an Apple leaker with a good track record, replied with a thumbs down emoji, suggesting they think Prosser is wrong. But Prosser is in line with the leak above, and Gurman could have been referring to other product launch dates that Prosser spoke about in the same tweet. Not every source agrees with this date though. One has suggested the iPhone 12 range could be just days away, while on the other hand, another fairly recent release date rumor points to an announcement in the second half of October. Another report on the matter, which comes from multiple suppliers in China, suggests that the iPhone 12 range won't be announced until late October, with the 4G models hitting stores shortly after, while the 5G iPhone 12 models won't go on sale until November. On the other hand, a source has now suggested that it's actually the 5G models that will land first, with the 4G ones potentially not arriving until early 2021, so we're not sure what's accurate there. So we can't be certain of an iPhone 12 release date yet, but our best guess for now is October 13. In any case, we're sure to hear more from Apple in the near future. The iPhone 12 price is something that leaks have made a little clearer than the release date, and from what we're hearing, it's likely to stay broadly in line with 2019's iPhone range. Prices for the next iPhone range probably won't be exactly the same though, which contains information taken from one big leak from YouTuber John Prosser. We've also included information from another leak, which suggests there will be 4G variants of two of the models. There's no clear information about prices for the UK or Australia, but we'd expect those to be last year's iPhones. Analyst Jeff Pooh has claimed the basic model of the phone may start at $749. So that would make it $100 more than that earlier leak suggested for the same amount of storage, and other leaked prices from this source are similarly increased. However, the source doesn't have much of a track record, so we take this with a pinch of salt. But this theory does line up with a previous report that suggested that the cost of materials for the iPhone 12 range might go up, which could mean higher prices at retail. That's not to say the phones will cost that much more at launch, especially as Apple seems to be cutting costs elsewhere, with reports of the battery board being a lot cheaper than in the iPhone 11, and the phones potentially not coming bundled with earbuds or a charging plug, but it could mean a price increase of some amount. We're expecting the iPhone 12 range to use a 5nm A14 Bionic chipset, which is almost certain to be included in the new iPhones, thanks to it being debuted with the new iPad Air 2020. The new processor inside will be capable of greater power efficiency, with 6 cores inside, and a 16-core neural engine that's battery life, or both, are the things we're waiting to see outlined on stage. An A14 Bionic Leap benchmark showed it had a single-core and multi-score score that was ahead of the Snapdragon 865, the processor we've seen in almost all Android flagships in 2020, so it seems set to be, again, one of the most powerful mobile chipsets around. Having said that, a more recent benchmark supposedly for the iPhone 12 Pro Max reveals scores that are lower than the Snapdragon 865 Plus, the top Android chipset of 2020. The overall score is also only around 9% higher than the iPhone 11 Pro Max, suggesting that Apple's focus on efficiency might mean there's less focus on raw power. That said, the scores are still good, and the iPhone 12 range is sure to be very powerful. The RAM could also get a boost, with analysts claiming that the iPhone 12 Pro and iPhone 12 Pro Max will have 6GB of the stuff, up from 4GB on their predecessors, though the standard phone will apparently stick with 4GB. This is something we've now heard again and again, so it may well be true. And Chinese publication Kaifa News also suggests Apple and other manufacturers may soon use GaN power adapters. These are currently used by Xiaomi and allow for fast charging speeds up to 65 watts. There's no guarantee this will debut on the iPhone 12 or any future iPhone for that matter, but it may mean we see an improved fast charging experience along. Note that it includes 5G information. The iPhone 12 design looks set to be a big change from the latest few generations of Apple's handset. Remember the iPhone 4 and iPhone 5. Reports suggest that the iPhone 12 range will be in part inspired by those phones, and there's supposedly even some elements of the iPad Pro 2020 mixed in. The rear of all four phones is still expected to be made of glass, but the edges are expected to be more squared than the rounded ones on current models. They make comparisons to the design of the iPad Pro, saying that the iPhone 12 Pro and iPhone 12 Pro Max will have flat stainless steel edges, more sharply rounded corners, and flat screens. These are non-functioning devices that case makers use to design accessories for the phones ahead of launch, so they could well be accurate, but they could just as easily be fake. In any case, there are certainly some errors with them, as the camera setup doesn't match what we're expecting, more on which below, but you can see that the design appears less curvy than the iPhone 11 range, lining up with other leaks. Cases for the iPhone 12 range have started being listed too, and these also show only given for the iPhone 12 Pro Max though, which is apparently 7.4mm, down from 8.1mm on the iPhone 11 Pro Max. And the phones might not just be slim. A separate leak has suggested the standard, supposedly 5.4-inch, iPhone 12 looks smaller than the iPhone 7, but isn't as small as the original. Below provides another look at the possible 5.4-inch iPhone 12. We've also heard from John Prosser, a leaker with a good track record, that the iPhone 12 and iPhone 12 Max will have aluminum frames, and that the iPhone 12 Pro and iPhone 12 Pro Max will have stainless steel ones, and that all four phones will have smaller notches than the iPhone 11 range. The iPhone 12 Pro at least could have the old notch design, rather than a smaller notch, a large wave antenna cutout, and a different camera arrangement to what we've seen in other leaks. iPhone 12 range dummy units that appear to be in line with this, as well as having flat edges. That said, other reputable sources seem skeptical of these leaks, particularly when it comes to the camera, so we take them with a pinch of salt. For now, we'd say the leaks and details towards the top of the section are more likely to be right. Advertisement. Finally, one thing that we are expecting is that the iPhone 12 range will be water resistant. It's very likely that Apple will retain the IP68 water and dust resistance rating found on the iPhone 11 range for the next iPhone, which means it will be able to be submerged in water. Cable. Braided cables tend to be more durable, but we take this with a pinch of salt, and even if it's accurate, it's unclear whether all or just some iPhone 12 models would get this. iPhone 12 colors. We've heard a rumor that Apple will be debuting a navy blue on its top-end models. Reports say the midnight green color that debuted on the iPhone 11 Pro sold beyond Apple's expectations, so the company may also decide to keep that, or it may be replaced in the lineup by this navy shade. That dark blue rumor has actually resurfaced more recently, which makes us think that there might be something to it. The iPhone 11 Pro and Pro Max were available in space gray, silver and gold alongside midnight green. Those shades may remain. As for the standard phone, we're expecting a similar pastel range to the iPhone 11. That phone is available in black, green, yellow, purple, red and white, so you should probably expect some of those colors to return for 2020's device. If this is accurate, then we'd be seeing a non-Pro Max model for the first time in the form of the iPhone 12 Max. It looks set to have a larger screen size than the standard iPhone 12, designed for those who don't want to spend lots on an iPhone 12 Pro Max model, but want a larger phone. That said, the size is actually in line with the iPhone 11, so rather than making a bigger basic iPhone, Apple has seemingly shrunk the standard model, and if this information is right, then you still only have three sizes to choose from, with the iPhone 12 Max supposedly being the same size as the iPhone 11. Display Zoom allows you to change the size of the interface on an iPhone to match that of a smaller screen iPhone. So for example, the 6.5-inch iPhone 11 Pro Max can switch to a 5.8-inch display view, which makes all the icons bigger and more zoomed in. However, now there's an option for a 9.4-inch model on a production line. The iPhone 11 features an LCD display, while the iPhone 11 Pro features OLED technology. So a move to OLED on all of them may allow for a far stronger screen on the standard iPhone 12 models, although we don't yet have any clear details on the resolution you can expect from any of the four phones' displays. The other big rumored change for the 2020 iPhone display is the move to a 120Hz refresh rate. The current iPhones and a lot of other smartphones sport a refresh rate of 60Hz, so upping that to 120Hz makes the screen reload quicker and gives you a smoother experience when scrolling through social media feeds or gaming. That is all for now, guys.